Melee attacks are performed via the light attack and heavy attack buttons. Each attack strength causes a different enemy hit reaction as your blows connect. Light attacks are generally quick to execute, deal low damage, and trigger a short damage animation. Heavy attacks are slower to execute, but deal higher damage and trigger a longer damage animation. You are not committed to melee attack animations as they execute. You are free to cancel out of the animation at any point. The aim, jump, and dodge actions will interrupt just about any attack animation, as will command attacks such as the shove or spin attack. Each of the game's melee weapons has a variety of combo chains. These are preset sequences of attacks triggered via sequential light attack and heavy attack inputs. These combo chains are not merely cosmetic variations. Each chain triggers a unique set of hit reactions, predetermined damage animations the enemy will exhibit as each hit connects. Combo chains have a consistent structure, and it's the hit reaction assigned to each strike within the chain which provides this structure. Generally, hit reactions which affect the enemy slightly are at the beginning of combo chains, while severe effects are towards the end. This structure encourages the player to finish combo chains in order to inflict the most useful hit reactions. Hit reactions leave the enemy unable to act for varying amounts of time, depending on their severity. These predetermined damage animations can simply leave the enemy unable to act for a brief period, or physically change the position of the enemy in relation to the player character. Knowing the effects of each hit reaction allows you to string together a huge number of attacks in countless ways. This not only enables the creation of amazing looking combos, but also gives you the ability to ad-lib as the situation dictates. Once you learn this system, your judgment in tight situations will be based on absolute knowledge rather than chance. The base hit reaction interrupt causes the enemy to flinch or stumble, leaving it unable to act for a brief period. This basic hit reaction has both a light and heavy attack strength variant. As heavy attacks generally take longer to execute and deal more damage, the associated hit reaction lasts longer. The vertical launch will cause an enemy to be blasted upwards to the height of a single jump before falling back down to its feet. This hit reaction perfectly sets a target up for an aerial combo, a technique covered in greater detail in a later episode. You cannot inflict a vertical launch on an enemy's alt form. In this situation, the vertical launch will be replaced by a sweep hit reaction. Typically triggered via specific combo chains, the diagonal launch will violently blast an enemy diagonally away from the player character. As the initial strike is so powerful, your target will not land back on its feet. Instead, the enemy will collapse to the ground on impact, effectively extending the duration in which it is unable to act. Diagonal launch attacks set you up nicely for a vehicle attack or gun chain follow-up. Or you can simply jump towards the enemy and perform an aerial combo chain. Connecting a back turn attack will spin the enemy around 180 degrees with a slight pause before it turns back to face you. This pause gives you an opportunity to land additional attacks. Moreover, certain characters gain access to new techniques when an enemy has his back to him. Bumblebee will perform a sneaky back attack if you press the interact button when positioned behind an enemy. Grimlock can throw any regular sized enemy as soon as a back turn property strike connects. The stagger hit reaction is an exaggerated interrupt. As the enemy remains locked in the animation for a slightly longer duration, it is possible to use this hit reaction as a means to keep an enemy in place while you queue up attacks with longer startup animations. Where the stagger differs from the interrupt is in the motion of the enemy target. An interrupt holds the enemy in place during its animation, but the stagger can push an enemy backwards. Stun can either be inflicted by connecting a stun property attack or via a sustained barrage of attacks. Each enemy has an invisible stun gauge which fills up as they take damage. Once a critical threshold is met, the enemy will become stunned and unable to act for a considerable amount of time. Alternatively, there are attacks which have the stun hit reaction assigned to them. Simply connecting these attacks will trigger a stun instantly. Like the back turn, the stun can also enable additional attacks with certain characters. Grimlock can throw an enemy while it is stunned, or at the very instant a stun property strike connects. The knockdown hit reaction is typically applied to powerful, close-range attacks triggered at the end of combo chains. Such attacks will slam the enemy directly to the ground, the impact leaving it in a down state and unable to act for a considerable amount of time. It is possible to pick up enemies as they lay in a down state after a knockdown. Press the interact button near a downed enemy to pick it up. From here, you have access to the following actions. Pressing the light attack button will swing the enemy as a weapon. Heavy attack will slam the enemy directly to the ground. The ranged weapon button will throw the enemy. It is possible to aim your throw with the right analog stick. If performed in the air, the knockdown functions as an inverse vertical launch. With this technique, it is possible to slam an enemy directly to the ground during an aerial combo, allowing you to follow up with a helm breaker or ground slam. The sweep hit reaction occurs when you trip an enemy, causing it to fall to the ground momentarily helpless. Although this hit reaction leaves your target sprawled on the ground, it cannot be followed up with a throw. Instead, use the opportunity to follow up with a gun chain leading to a vehicle attack. Knockback attacks will blast your target away with such force that it becomes a projectile, capable of interrupting other enemies in its path. A wall splat will occur if the enemy impacts a wall, locking the enemy in an additional damage animation. Although knockback attacks blast your target a significant distance, you can still follow up in a variety of interesting ways. Most knockbacks will trigger a vehicle attack flash on hit. These additional attacks allow you to quickly close the gap between your character and target. The flurry hit reaction is an extremely rapid barrage of interrupts which strikes so quickly that the enemy remains locked in hit stun for the entire duration of the attack. The flurry hit reaction not only looks impressive, it's actually unbreakable. Many enemy types have the ability to break out of hit stun. By incorporating the flurry hit reaction into your attack sequences, you will reduce the chance of your combos being broken before you get a chance to deal serious damage.